the world's biggest aluminum smelting and rolling plant. Here in Neuss in western Germany, huge machines roll blocks of aluminum into long strips. The Aluminium Norf company processes more than 1 million tons of aluminum every year. Every second beverage can in Europe is made from material fabricated here in Neuss. Light metal is also indispensable in the automotive and printing industries. The light metal made in Neuss can be melted down an infinite number of times in the plant's furnaces without any loss of quality. This means that a used beverage can be made into a new beverage can, and an engine hood can be turned into another engine hood. The challenge is that there are roughly 200 different alloys. And to produce a specific alloy, primary or pure aluminum is required. This is pure aluminum in the form of ingots. We have to add this to our products. It is produced using electrolysis and requires a lot of energy. If we use recycled material, we save up to 95% of the energy. So that makes a lot of sense. The company's goal is to use as little of the energy-intensively produced primary aluminum as possible and produce less CO₂ in doing so. Over 600 buckets of recyclable materials arrive at the plant every day. The buckets are full of either production waste from the company's own plant or discarded metal from production at other companies. In order to minimize the use of primary or pure aluminum, an automatic batch intelligence system, BIS for short, coordinates the material flows. At the beginning, each individual bucket is weighed. The containers are then automatically transported to one of the company's two huge warehouses. This is where the buckets are placed. A central computer knows exactly which alloy, with which weight, is in which of the approximately 1,800 buckets. Alloy 5537, for example. The atomic lattice mainly contains aluminum atoms. However, there is also magnesium. This increases the strength of the material. Another bucket contains the aluminum alloy 8136. In addition to aluminum, there are also copper atoms in the atomic lattice. This alloy is therefore easy to form. The quantity of certain alloying elements in the metallic bonding determines the material properties of the aluminum. In order to use as much recycled material as possible, buckets are selected from the hundreds of possibilities in which the alloying elements are present in the quantities necessary. This way, an alloy with specific properties can then be produced. A tilting crane places the containers that will be used into a so-called charging basket. The crane will transport the metal to the furnace later in the process. The batch calculator plays an important role in planning the entire process. With the batch intelligence system, it can calculate how much is needed of what ingredient. We use scrap to fill the batch. Recycled materials are 42 tons, and then there are 8 tons of pure aluminum. In this example, The batch intelligence system calculated that about 5 times more processed scrap or recycled materials can be used than pure aluminum in order to produce the required aluminum alloy. The Aluminium Norf plant has 13 furnaces in total. Both the recycled materials and the pure aluminum are melted down in these furnaces. Pure aluminum comes in the form of ingots. Ingots are bundled together and fed into the furnace. The primary aluminum must be absolutely dry. Even condensation would be dangerous, because there can be temperatures of up to 800 degrees Celsius in the furnace. If hydrogen were produced, it could lead to a violent explosion. While the furnace is being loaded with pure aluminum, work begins in the automatic warehouse. The batch intelligence system selects the containers with the appropriate alloys from over 1,000 buckets. These can contain up to 3 tons of recycled materials. According to the product that has been ordered, the transport system, steered by a computer, pours the contents of 11 buckets into the feed basket. Clearly defined quantities of specific alloy materials, including manganese, end up in the huge basket. The aim, in this case, is to produce a high-strength aluminum that is used, among other things, in the automotive industry. Once the charging basket is full, off it goes. Around 20 tons are lifted and transported through the hall. The 13 ovens are fed around the clock. Gas flames heat up the temperature of the furnaces to where it needs to be. The aluminum is dropped into the furnace. After around 2 hours, all the materials that were utilized have melted. There are up to 8 different alloying elements in the melt. The individual elements are no longer part of a lattice structure. In order for the substance being made to have the same material properties in the entire batch, the alloying elements need to be uniformly distributed in the molten aluminum. This is done by special stirring tools. The liquid metal has a temperature of more than 800 degrees Celsius. Absolute caution is required. After roughly 3 hours, a smelter takes an initial sample. This is analyzed immediately in the in-house laboratory. The lab checks whether the alloying elements are present in exactly the right concentration. Only then can the molten metal be transferred to the casting plant. The results of the sample test just arrived. It's almost perfect. I only need to transfer about 20 kilos of iron into the furnace. Then my colleagues can start pouring it. The result is impressive. Although there are about 50,000 kilograms of material in the furnace, a mere 20 kilograms of iron needed to be added to put together the alloy. If there were too many alloying elements in the furnace, the melt would have to be diluted with pure aluminum. And if there were too few alloying elements in the melt, These would have to be added. However, there is always the possibility that too many of these alloys can then be added again, and so on and so forth. This kind of process of gradual approximation is very raw material intensive. It also takes time, and therefore a lot of energy. The batch intelligence system, or BIS for short, is a huge help. It saves us time and money. We also use fewer ingots because all the parts of the alloys are mixed together, and we get notified right away if we need to adjust. Once the correct concentration of all alloying elements has been reached, the liquid aluminum flows to a casting plant. Here it is poured into molds, which are cooled. Once the material has solidified, a block that can weigh up to 34 tons is lifted using a special gripper. The aluminum block, which is several meters long, then has to further cool down. The block then continues to be processed using a milling machine, among other things. The aluminum block then travels along a conveyor line to a special hot rolling mill. Here, four rollers with a total of 5,000 tons of pressure process the metal. This procedure is repeated up to 27 times. The result is an aluminum strip that is around 2 meters wide, around 45 millimeters thick, and around 200 meters long. The rolling continues, and coils are produced that are used as a material in aluminum processing companies. And this is how beverage cans or engine hoods can be produced using less primary aluminum. We would like to reduce using primary aluminum with our BIS system. The goal was to save 45,000 tons of aluminum per year. We are convinced, however, that we can save up to 70,000 tons. The system works extremely well. It is better than we previously calculated. It can also be used for other industries, such as those working with non-ferrous metals or even in the steel industry. It's not just for the aluminum industry. Aluminium Norf is not the only company melting metal. There is also an iron foundry that works like this. There is, however, one basic problem. There are approximately 200 different alloys for aluminum and as many as 2,000 for iron, which means companies do not have the information regarding the specific alloys in the scrap metal being used. Intelligent control of the individual recycling materials is a system that can also be used by other foundries and metal smelters. This groundbreaking innovative technology could help to save vast quantities of material and reduce CO₂ as well, not just in the world's largest aluminum smelting and rolling plant.